on the road again. Just can't wait to get on the road again. The life I love is making music with my friends. And I can't wait to get on the road again.
Hi guys. Today I thought I'd do a little video showing how to recover Foden 6x6 using a chain lift. Not something people use very much these days, but back in the old days with the army stuff, a chain lift used to be used pretty commonly. It was kind of the main way to go. So I'll get the gear out and show you how it's done. Right, I'm going to be using my Foden 8-wheeler, and I will get the Foden 6x6 picked up at the front, and I'll tow it up the yard to show you how you go on with it. So today I'm going to be using the medium extension pedestals. They're my two safety breakaway straps. These are the two lifting chains, and these here are the chain lifting forks, or pig's feet as they get called. So I'll get it all set up there now. Right, the first job is to get a shackle on the front eyes. There's a few ways of lifting them with a chain lift, but I always found when I recovered them down to Catterick, this was the best way. So we need to place a safety strap through there, and then one of our lifting chains will go through. I'll go around and I'll do the same on the other side. Okay, we'll get this one on this side. Yep. One strap and one chain on. These are 50-ton bow shackles. Not so much for the weight, but for just a good size shackle for the job. So what we'll do now is we get one of these chains and we'll place it over the top. I'll do the same on the other side. Take this chain over. To extend the underlift out, get the pig's feet on, and then get the chains in. tight there now, you see? Yep, she's lifting good there, so what I'll do, I'll let her back down. And then what I'll do now, before I get it up, is I'll put the straps on and I'll air it up. Right, we'll get some air into it with these palm couplings. Just if you wet your mouth, put a bit of spit on them, because they're two rubbers, and if you don't, it sometimes bunches the rubber up. So that's a top tip. A little bit of spit on. I put it through the shackle there so it clears, because it's tight. So that's that one on. So now, get the yellow one on it, again, a little bit of spit on it. You can hear it charging up there now. There we go. So we've got the red and the yellow line on. So that's the red to blow your brakes off, the yellow to brake the casualty. If you listen, you can actually hear it charging there. That's a good sign. Okay, what I'm going to do now, I'm going to lift it up and then bring it in. I've got the handbrake off. There we go, that's her picked up there now. Well, I'll just tie off the chains. Safety strap. I'll run to the back of the wrecker. Right, that's her all picked up there. Red line on, yellow line on. You can see her sitting in the forks there. Lovely. Chained over the top, solid. I've got the chains around the inside of this bolt here, so you're not gonna end up with it slipping past and off the side of the lifting plate there. So, transfer box in neutral, brakes off. You don't need to prop off on a foden as long as that transfer box is in neutral. Underlift, I've got a bit of an angle on it there, but probably about as far as I dare go with it towing something like that because of that angle. I don't want to put strain on the pin. I think if I was going to be going down the road, this is just a demonstration. I'll put a higher set of pedestals on, and that would take the angle off that and lift, make it a bit better. But hey, just a demonstration. So, she sits well with the old Foden on, doesn't she? Right, I'll give her a drag up the road for you. Well, guys, I hope that helps anyone that needs to drag their Foden in someday. I hope you enjoyed that, and like I say, it was only a demonstration. So there's other ways of doing it, but that's one good way of doing it, safe way of doing it. So if you like that, don't forget to like and subscribe. As always, thanks for watching, and I'll see you again with another Ken's Jobs.